So imagine that Chris Medlin from Atlanta Braves is the pitcher and Martin Prado from Arizona Diamondbacks is at the bat. Chris Medlin has the goal of finishing the inning without allowing any runs. How does Chris Medlin decide on an action? We may conceptualize Medlin's decision-making like the following. Medlin may look at various choices that are available to him. He may throw a pitch, or he may choose to walk the batter. If he walks the batter, then there are additional possibilities that open up. He'll need to face the next batter. If he chooses to pitch, then he'll have to decide what kind of ball to throw, a slider, a fastball, or a curveball. If he throws a slider, then there is a next set of possibilities open up. There might be a strike, or a ball, or a hit, or he may just strike the batter out. Thus, Medlin is setting up a state space. Now, what we just stated informally can be stated formally. So we can imagine a number of states in the state space. The state space is a combination of all these states that can be achieved by applying various combinations of operators starting from the initial state. Each state can be described in terms of some features, F1, F2, there could be more. Each feature can take on some values. For example, V1, there might be a range of values here. So initially the pitcher is at state S0 and the pitcher wants to achieve some state S101, and in the state S101, presumably the pitcher's goal has been accomplished. So we may think of the pitcher's decision making as some kind of a path from its current state to this particular goal state. This is an abstract space. The pitcher has not yet made any action. The pitcher is still thinking. The pitcher is setting up an abstract state space in his mind and exploring that state space.